Amongst others, the Namibia Public Passenger Transport Association is accusing the Namibia Bus and Taxi Association of trying to steal their members. The two associations had a closed-door meeting with the police for several hours. It is understood that the two associations were up in arms over passengers yesterday.
The scenario there in Reno Park, the MPPTI have got their table and the NAPTA have got their table. But unfortunately, MPPTI have got more members there. Now they found it is quite difficult for them to regulate everything. They want to be have got an office, one office where a commuter, when they come, they go to that office and they register there, either from NAPTA or which we found it quite difficult because our member, they come to our table and then their member go to their table. If there is a thing of the new office to be allocated, it needs also to be discussed by both sides. We are not saying we don't want to go to that office, but if we are going to be allowed to have got our table there and their table there, which is not a problem, what we want is order.
On the other hand, NAPTA simply says they are trying to bring law and order at the bus terminal, and they want the current situation whereby passengers make payments at the bus terminal to change. They want all the payments to be made at their offices for apparent safety reasons.
We do not want to foresee any longer a passenger is being giving money to a loading master of NAPTA or to a loading master of anybody outside, because it is not safe, the security is in danger, because anybody can come and grab the money from the commuter or do any other funny things to rob the commuters or the bus or the loading masters. So for the safety of the loading master, for the safety of the communities, so they have to pay their money inside the offices as other countries are doing.
While the two associations are at each other's throats, they still have a pending case in court against Puma, the landlord of the premises. Puma wants the tenants evicted, but there is resistance. The case will be in court this Friday. This is Aaron Shaukwa reporting for the News on One.